What's good, man? We back on TTV, man.
What up, man?
And if it's your first time, man, definitely won't be your last. Make sure you kill, murder, and
smash
that subscribe button. Y'all want some full reaction, uncut reactions of Fire Force, Bleach, One Piece. Yo. We also got movies, man. We got Justice League, Snack, Zack Snyder Cut, man. We got all the Spider-Man movies, man, and a lot more. And a yearly subscription will get you a month for free. Join the family. Y'all be messing up too, man. I don't want to have nothing, yeah.
And make sure you give this video a like and have that notification bell ringing for that Fire Force playlist. And make sure you follow us on Spotify, the RTTV show, where we talk about some of your favorite genres of music, such as K-pop, hip-hop, R&B, and much, much more. So make sure you follow and subscribe Spotify, the RTTV show.
And we back with one of the most, like, I'll say, well-animated shows of this generation. We got Fire Force, and we left off a crazy ass moment. Mm-hmm. We seen that they actually visited the fourth precinct. Mm-hmm. We had that dude that got scarred back in the day when he was in one of the Odalo links.
Yep.
And we seen that Shinra actually went evil because it was like a pillar that was within his subconscious, like an abomination that was messing with his thoughts, mm-hmm. his anger. And then he went all out. And then Ra's boy Arthur, King Arthur himself, had his son Shinra real quick, get his mind right. And then Shinra knocked himself back into his senses.
Ooh. Stay tuned.
Yeah. But yo, right now we're actually currently looking for another pillar, another Odalo bearer, you could say, stuff like mm-hmm. that. Because right now the Evangelist is on the hills, man. So yo, you fellas ready?
Bring on the fire kick, Shinra.
Let's get it, baby. Fire Force Season 2, Episode 3 and 4. See, I wonder if that pillar's a baby or is like 10 years old, 16. That was kind of creepy. So she's like a demon that's been around for like thousands of years, probably. He looks kind of lit, yo. I don't even know if I can fully trust this dude. He said, I bet. That's all I needed to know. That ass, though. Arthur came in the clutch. Man, they better hope that other bearer isn't like fast tempered. You feel me? Or got like an anger issue, because that's an L right there. It seems like that's what the Evangelist feed off of. Now, I respect the chief for that. It's like, yo, I made you like the captain of the eighth, so you can have free roam to do whatever you want. You investigate how you want to do it, bruh. So I was like, at least he got the backing behind him.
Never. That's Captain Obi.
Oh, that's something you would say.
Exactly.
Not.
Whoa.
She may be the thing.
Yeah, the little bit. Yeah.
Yeah.
Oh, she has her own crew?
Yeah. I wonder what time they are. Mm. See, it is fire. Mm. Yeah, she sniffed out fires. Oh, maybe what they do is that they basically, she sniffs out fires so they can go into it and rob it or something like that before it fully burns down or something.
Wow, she knows it before it starts.
Yeah, that's really what's about to happen.
Yeah, she might end up joining the Fire Force.
My boy got a Friday the 13th mask on. Yeah, you're right, though. There's a possibility she actually might join the precinct, though, because she's not evil. She's trying to catch a lick.
Nah, she's messed up, though, because at that point, if you could sniff it out before it happens, wouldn't you just get people to save them?
Yeah, right. Oh, she still saves them. It costs.
Wow.
That's messed up.
That's facts.
Oh, okay, she's the only one that can pinpoint where it is. Because she's the bearer.
Oh. Okay.
Yep. She don't even understand what she is.
The riots? With the riots? The LA riots or something?
He said Hades.
Oh, Hades. Huh? Oh, Aries. My fault. I thought you said 80s.
I said Hades.
That is what it is. Yeah.
No, 80s. 80s. Like 1980s, not Hades. So that's why I said LA riots. So I was like, oh, word.
I'm not going to lie. I was confused on how you got there. I was like, what?
Wait, so at that moment, that's when her Adalo Flame was born, huh?
Yeah, she's probably is going to join the precinct, and she'll definitely be clutch to tell them, hey, where an attack is coming from at a certain point in time.
Especially if she can tell when somebody's about to spontaneously combust.
Yeah.
Oh, no, it hasn't been born yet. She's trying to expedite it. She about to smile. See?
So creepy. So creepy.
Nah, we might not get her, bro.
Maybe.
She likes danger, and the girl placing. Aw, man. I love how they do the animation for, like, how they appear in the sound effects. Huh? Yeah.
I think we are about to get her, and Shinra's gonna be the one to save her.
Wait, what the?
It's like she's seeing mad fires at once.
It's like LA wildfire.
Even crazy, cause this was in the city. Like,
actually, I don't know, Pat. You might be right.
She's tapped, bro.
Yeah, cause that was crazy.
Yeah, like she enjoys the thrill of danger. So it's like, if the Evangelist is like, yo, we can strike up as much danger as you want. She's gonna be bad. I can have as much fun as I want. See? She's wildin'.
What type of conductor is she? She the Beethoven of fires.
We can't take an L, bro.
We take an L on that one. I don't know.
Yeah, it's like, bro, know. That's like missing out.
Who y'all got? Evangelist. Evangelist?
You came at me earlier?
Yeah. That's the one thing I definitely can't pronounce.
You said Eva Angelus?
The Evangelist of the, whatchamacallit, or Fire Force?
I don't know. Right now, I'll go with the Evangelist, but I don't know. I want the Fire Force to win.
Let's get it!
Fire for Shinra!
Wait, what? She has the power that she's able to read people's thoughts. And then she could... Wow! And put it in their heads.
Oh, so they know where she's at, too.
It's like they use, like, a frequency in their brain. They can channel all at once.
bow.
Oh! Oh!
Whoa!
Yo, have we seen anything that gory in this show yet? What?
Wow, I don't even know, bro. That was, wow. Wow, wow. Oh, my God.
What?
Yeah, right? Yo, so soda came off.
Start.
Wait, oh. What the hell?
She can create fire.
Wait, so this is what she's seeing? Like, what the hell?
Yeah, fire. She's doing that.
That's kind of different. I never seen that. Like, it shows on screen how she's able to do her move.
Yeah!
Told you! Told you!
He didn't really do much, though. But, like, come on, man. You gotta, damn shit, Rob. I was rooting for you, man.
I was waiting for him to attack. Oh, okay, wow. There it is. There it is.
He looks like a Shin. Let's go, Shin. Let's go.
Nah, this dude's nice,
damn,
bro.
Who is this guy?
Yeah, Shin right now. Oh, wow, he's not strong enough.
Oh, my gosh. Yo, he looks like a character from Street Fighter.
Nah, he does, bro.
Nah, this dude
this
is
dude's
OP,
lit,
bro.
Yo, wow. I rock with him.
Wow.
Hell yeah, that's a real stepper. And he's a black man too. It makes it even better.
Oh,
oh
my
whoa.
Gosh, no.
So everybody just spontaneously combusted out of nowhere. Bro, I'm not gonna sit here talking about all my town. I'm running, bro. There's no way.
Put my husband out of his misery.
Nah, I don't care. We're calling up the other precincts. There's a lot to handle by ourselves.
Maybe it's not their jurisdiction.
That's definitely the case. Oh, damn!
Damn, Volkan.
That's not even a regular one, too. Volkan really came and Ray gave him, like, real deal technology that they could put to use. Oh, there she is.
She could tap into that frequency, though.
You think so?
I mean, I know she can tap into frequency, so I don't know.
Nah,
why
yeah, you're right. Yeah, exactly. It makes sense. Yo, Shinra, violate this dude. Let's go.
Let's
get
go.
Him off his feet real
hey.
Quick. Finally.
He felt that.
She said, I like danger.
I don't want to be safe. That's the problem. Hey, man, you can want to be safe all you want. Don't put that shit on me.
What the hell's happened?
She's doing she's like creating the ignition or whatever.
Nah, but that's emerging in front of her and stuff like that. So if she successfully does that right there, it must be a big move that's gonna happen after. You see what I'm saying? Like, so she has to follow that whole guide mm-hmm. to get to the goal, and once she hits the goal, it'll be an explosion or whatever.
It's gonna be a crazy one.
Yeah.
That's like the things they had at the doctor's office.
Yeah, I used to love those. Like, whoop whoop. I haven't seen those in a minute, yo.
Me neither. Kids don't remember that, John.
Oh, good block.
Let's go, Shinra. Shinra never skips leg day.
I knew it.
Oh, no.
I was like, you're about to be a giant one. Damn.
It's probably a legendary one. A demon.
Oh, it's one of the demon ones.
Oh, he looked dope.
It's a different type of demon one. Yeah, bro, I don't know. I don't know how they're going to take this dub without Benny Marvel or something, somebody popping up.
Dope, bro, don't. Captain Obi, dog.
Who you need to call, Benny Maru? Oh my god.
Of course she had to get naked, yo. It wouldn't be Tamaki if her she didn't strip for the guys real quick. Oh, what?
No.
Who's that?
Isn't that one of the dudes from the first? That's dude from the
first.
Yeah,
that is dude from the first. Yeah. You're right. Homie, they got the bell. Hey, yeah. Hey,
nah, he's lit.
I was about to be like, use your feet. Oh. Oh my god.
Damn, they're doing it to him right now.
Wow.
Yeah, it was my boy. Oh, that's somebody else from the first. Yeah. What?
He said, I got a pack of tropical fruit bubblicious and some Skittles.
Fifth. He's the one that's with the homegirl, the baddie.
Oh, they coming in hot. Oh,
coming in hot.
Gosh. Complete devastation. Oh, I remember him.
So there's a whole bunch of everybody from different precincts. This is dope.
Oh my gosh. Yo. Imagine just catching a fire nuke in your stomach, bruh. That'd be terrible.
I've had fire in my stomach before. It was so good.
Was it a nuke?
I dropped a nuke after. The reinforcements are really putting in work right now.
Shinro! I like this dude, though. He's a beast.
I rock with him, too. Yeah, for sure.
Nah, he's nasty. Oh, wow. Wow.
Nah, he's teeing up on Shinro,
bro. Oh, my gosh.
Oh! That was fire.
Let's go, Shinro!
Let's go Fire Force. They always make
him lit. Nobody affects him, though.
What?
That's probably the wildest I ever heard.
I want to live where crazy. I'm scared.
Every day.
Yes.
Danger.
Bring on the scares.
Bring on snowfall.
At that point, I'm pulling an Evan and just being like, yeah, nah, you got that. What you want me to do?
Like, yo.
You got that.
Yeah, I'm not going to lie. I'll stop trying to save you once you say some shit like that. I think you're the devil. You want to be scared all the time, every day? Nah, I'm good.
I have a lot of time, yo. If you come to the 8th precinct, dangerous every day, yo. I'm telling you. Yeah, we even got more nurses. I mean, sisters. I said nurses.
You said nurses.
I'm going to say nuns.
Yo. This guy said nurses.
I feel you, Pat, man. They could be both. Shout out to Obi, man. My boy got the reinforcements.
You see him? You see him?
Oh. Oh.
She got a whole barrier. Ready.
Oh my gosh, bro.
He's black and blind. I love him. Like, that's my character. I'm taking him. This is all the character design.
Oh!
Into the thunderclap. Nah, this is lit.
Oh my, yo, Shiver's
this
getting
this animation
his ass
going crazy too
right now, bro.
Walk.
That is dope.
Yo, they got so many lift fights going on right now at once.
This sequence is fire, bro. No pun intended.
Rock. No.
Ah.
Damn it.
Pat, it's all your fault.
I'm about to leave him sick. Yo. We are damn season 2.
That was real.
Yo. Came to they ain't playing this season right here. And I feel like They was able to maintain what we love from Fire Force is the animation. But I feel like one element that I feel like they even like stepped it up even more is the actual like story and the villains too. Cause homie that's giving Shinra the works right now, bro, that's a fire ass villain right there, man. But how y'all feeling so far about this, man?
I think the fights in this were just A1. Everything was A1 in both episodes, especially like even when Shorty was like, she was detecting the fires and she was just like,
yeah, that's Symphony.
Yeah, and she was doing the conductor thing. Like, I think this villain, this new evangelist, he's just a savage. Like, he can't be stopped. He seems like he's damn near impossible. Like, Shinra's throwing anything and everything at him, and he's not going down for nobody. Like, and even the new, the demon, what was it called? The demon fire thing?
Demon Inferno?
The Demon Inferno. Yeah. Wow. I try to make that 10 times more complicated than it was. But the Demon Inferno, like that showing up, that even added more like suspense and drama to the fight scenes. Arthur and his fight against the Thunder Chick, like everything down to a T and down to the animation is just amazing. Fire Force is just an amazing show.
It's on 100 right now.
Yo, shout out to Fire Force because these last two episodes was crazy. Like from the storyline, like they have me so locked in on everything right now.
Yep.
Like, yo, so the actual Fire Force was in a tough situation. They got the Walking Dead of Infernals. Then you get the Demon Infernal. Luckily, my boy Captain Obi called in reinforcements because they was about to get smoked.
Nah, they was going
to
get washed, bro.
But then my boy was even like, all right, yo, so word, we got this under control, but the whole goddamn city is burning down. Like, so we either got to fight them or save the city. What are we going to do?
Yep.
So now they're in an interesting situation. Now that girl is just a nut. She's a nut, bro. Like, yeah. I want to be scared all the time. I love it. Like, I don't want to be safe. Like, I don't even understand that. Like, it intrigues me where she's going to go with it. Because somehow I think she's going to be part of Fire Force. But, like, I don't know. Like, we got to change that paradigm. Because how the hell? Yeah. I don't even want to deal with somebody like that. Like,
yeah. It's not dangerous enough today.
Yeah, we're in the middle of the Fire Force.
You better sit your dumb ass down.
Yeah. It's crazy, bro. And then the way homie, like, yo, when he just said,
BOW!
I was like, yo. I was like, homie, don't play. And like, I think Battle Beast is probably a better fighter because Battle Beast, like, once he started swinging, it was just like all over. But like, this dude, you just can't hurt him.
Yeah.
Like, I don't know. Like, put it this way. That's why I'm suiting for the next episode because now he's going to try his next. He got to level up.
Yep.
He got to level up and use the move that Obi told him to even have a chance. But this dude, bro, they kicking him in the face. Shorty was sitting here, fire igniting him. He's like, relax, yo. Yo, chill. Like, yo, I'm going to get you. Relax. All right, yo, all right. You like, I'm not even feeling nothing, so.
You crazy.
Y'all turned the hell up.
He don't want no smoke with Battle Beast.
Yo, Shinra definitely is doing his thing. Just keeping up with that type of competitor and not getting violent. Because we've seen the most gruesome stuff we've seen in a lot of, probably this is top three most gruesome things we've seen in the anime we watched. He exploded his inside his intense, the blood was splattering. I feel like I was watching Invincible. And I like how Arthur is going to wash Shorty.
Cause you like my sneakers.
What are those?
Oh, wow. Balenciaga slides.
Yeah, but I think Fire Force is definitely, their fight scene is definitely up there with My Hero. Like, I'm not gonna lie, I didn't expect the fight scenes to go to the levels it's 1-2, and I'm like, this episode was unexpected but very appreciated. And I think that's the thing about Fire Force; it always gives you more than you expect, and more the merrier.
Yes, sir. You know what I noticed too? You're not gonna remember this because you never watched it. But remember how that Hunter and Phantom Troop, like in the New York City, where like they had that moment where he was doing like the symphony while all the things in explosion. I think they got that reference for this episode right here. It was the same thing. It's like explosions going off, and then she's over here doing the symphony with it. That was dope. And so right now they got a situation with this fifth O'Dollar bearer right now. It's like a situation where it's like kind of like where Steph Curry is, where his contract is expiring and he's about to, either he's going to stay with the Warriors or he's going to go somewhere else and stuff like that. And with this right here, it's like, yo, she got to choose who she's going to actually get traded to. Who do you think she's actually going to go to?
Well, Bob, I think that she's actually going to go. She's actually going to be a free agent because she's too crazy and she doesn't want to be an evangelist either, you know? And she's just way too crazy to be a part of the Fire Force. I don't think they could tame her.
So she's going to stay alone.
But in the case that they do tame her, I think that
Shinra will probably have a discussion with her and be like, you don't think that it's crazy that you want to just be around destruction? What about the people that you care about? Like,
doesn't seem like she has anybody that she cares about.
The city that burned down, friends. I think she lost a lot of her people.
Yeah, she even said that she lost her people.
She had her two friends. She told her other boy to run. Remember the fat dude to
that's
run.
The only person and, she, like she got
and,
left.
And that's still somebody, but that's still somebody that you could use. I don't know if Shinra's even going to get to meet him to use it as an advantage to be like, yo, you're wilding because the people around you could get hurt. You know what I'm saying? And if you care about these people, then maybe you shouldn't be so quick to be like, I want to be around danger all the time. You know what I'm saying?
I ain't gonna hold you, man. Right now, she doesn't seem like she's the person with the most emotions in the show.
Yeah.
Because, like, yo, they blew her friend off, like, his whole shit off, and he was like, she didn't really cry or nothing. She was just like, damn, why you do that? Like,
she did tell her other friend to run, though.
No, I mean, hey, no, Jerry, at this point, man, hey, Pat, they smoking people out here. You might want to run. Like, I feel it. But, like, I think, to keep, like, because you made a sports reference, I think basically right now she is she's going to get a chance to talk to both of them, and she's going to have to decide. Because right now I like that she don't want to go with none of them. Yeah. Like, yo, I want to do my own thing. Leave me the hell alone. So I think the Evangelist is going to get her now, and she's going to be able to learn what they about. And then I think the Fire Force is going to get her back, and then she's going to be able to learn what the Fire Force is about. And then she's having to make a decision. I got to be on one side because this is clearly a – either I'm gonna be this or that.
Yeah, she's very instrumental in regards to
each side. Either way, she has to pick a side. So I think that she'll end up picking Fire Force, but I do think that she's gonna have a time with both of them where she makes that decision.
Man, you talking crazy, Skip. I just really wanted to say that.
What?
Nah, I see what you're saying though. No bully though, because the thing about her is like, in both sides, she doesn't rock with either. Because even with the Evangelist, she's like, yo, this dude said, yo, you're going to be our pawn and stuff like that. So she's like, yo, no one's going to take control of me. But then at the same time, when Shinra and Fire forces them, it's like, yeah, you're trying to protect me. I ain't want no protection. I'm trying to be right next to danger. So honestly, what you said about being like kind of like a free, like standing alone, it kind of remind me of Young Justice, how they had that one dude that was like, he was by himself and stuff like that. He was like an archer. Like, he shot.
Red Arrow.
Yeah. So it kind of seems like, to me, when you said that, I'm like, yo, I could see her operating that way because she doesn't side with either or. But then eventually she got to choose a side regardless because she's very crucial to the whole plan on each side. So you're going to see the vibes, man. Mm-hmm. Season 2, heating up heavy over here on RTTV, man. Make sure you guys stay tuned, man. If it's your first time, man, definitely won't be your last. Make sure you kill, murder, and
smash
that subscribe button. Yo, Patrick RT here. Giving you guys with the probably the best animated show of this generation right now, man. Fire Force going dummy right now.
Wow. Bold statement.
It is.
That was a very bold statement.
Stand by it.
It's the man, the myth, the maniac, Wilkinson, the Squad RT. Shout out to Firefoot. Shout out to that boy, Firefoot Shinra. He is straight killer. Beat him up. I don't know the rest. I made up that rap. Like,
come on, man. Yo.
Cook him up. Oh, yeah.
This doesn't come off my head, bro. It's part of me. I'm like, oh, damn it.
Damn it, my guy.
Shit. Damn, yo, what's good, man? I go by the name of DC. You already know the vibes, man. Shout out to Fire Force. Y'all really turned all the way the hell up on these last two episodes. And I think that she's gonna learn a lot about herself through the Evangelist. So I think that's the plus right now. Because when homie was breaking it all down, she was like, Adolibus, Bearer, Link, what? Like, she has no idea what the hell. Fourth generation, fifth generation, pillar. Mm-hmm. What is this? Like, give me a definition, coach.
That was really the best way to say that. Adolibus, Evangelist, Link, what?
Yeah, it's like she was mad confused.
Draco. Hey, yo, that settles it at the round table.